What's going on, you bunch of filthy animals? We're back. If you haven't signed up for my Cal VPN, please go do it. Link in the bio. First VPN that's going to be able to protect you from quantum computers, and you'll want that. And I'm also doing another startup, and it's going to be like a Squarespace for YouTube creators. So it's going to help you guys out if you want to become YouTubers. I'm really pumped for that one. I think you guys might be really interested in what we're doing there, but I'll tell you more soon. Let's get into the video. I'm excited for today's video because it had such a beautiful title. Let's check. Oh, wait, I got to change it, don't I? All right, let's... Any day now. Check this out. What if Uranus collided with Earth? I just couldn't help myself. I had to click on it. Hopefully, you know, this isn't some strange clickbait, you know, shouldn't be on YouTube sort of video, but I guess we're going to find out. We're going to find out together. Let's check it out. I love Uranus.
It's been 30 days since Uranus first appeared in the sky.
I'm never going to be mature enough to not laugh at a joke like that.
First, it looked like our moon had found itself a stellar partner.
I'm glad the pug is mature enough to take this seriously.
Then we understood something much, much bigger was headed our way.
Uranus.
What caused Uranus to become so unstable? How could this epic collision change the ice giant?
What a way to go, huh? Straight into the abyss.
Oh, and what's this horrific stink? Nova
boys.
Ugh.
Yeah, it does smell like rotten eggs on Uranus.
Is what if?
It also rains diamonds, so, you know, don't bend over too much. Solid, big, thick diamonds. It's pretty amazing. This is real, by the way. On Neptune as well. So I'll just be standing out with my basket. And on Jupiter as well, it rains like neon. Neon streaks. What a sight to behold.
And here's what would happen if Uranus collided with Earth. Let's roll back 30 days, when things were still normal. Uranus lived a quiet life on the outskirts of our solar system, about 3 billion kilometers away from us.
Yeah, if you want some perspective, that Uranus is, what is it? It's 2.5 to 3 light hours away. All right, that's traveling at 300,000 kilometers per second. The moon, on average, is like 350,000 kilometers away. So it takes light just over a second to get to the moon. Right, that's pretty far away. You can drive a car in its lifetime about 300,000 to 400,000 kilometers. Every second, light is just, and it takes light. You can't travel faster because of the speed of causality. 3 hours just to get out to Uranus, and to give more perspective, it takes light on average about 12 minutes just to get out to Mars, and that's not a, you know, quick trip. We're struggling, and then, you know. Beyond that, you've got Neptune, that's about 4 light hours, so we're talking big distances here.
And then suddenly?
So far, in fact, we've only ever sent one probe out to explore these icy giants, Neptune and Uranus. They're still very, very mysterious, but we'll get into all of that because I love Uranus, and there's a lot I could say about it, even though it is still, you know, quite mysterious. But, you know, what's more beautiful than the mysterious?
It began to move closer. Astronomers would be the first to push the panic button. By their calculations, it would take Uranus 13 years to reach the collision point. We'd be short on time.
I'm interested to see if they give like a realistic scenario here for how this could happen. Because obviously, you know, that's just going to depend on how quick it's moving.
At least we'd have a slight chance to evacuate the Earth.
Like way too quick.
The cold blue giant had other plans in mind.
It is cold. It's the coldest planet in the solar system. You might think, well, why isn't Neptune colder? It's further away. It's colder. All right. Uranus is colder.
This would be
made of like... Sorry, I keep pausing it so much. We'll watch it properly in a second. It's made of like ammonia, water, and methane. Let's
watch. Standard planetary drill. Planets don't just take off from their orbits for no reason at all, but somehow Uranus did. Now it would be hurtling through the solar system, ramping up to a speed of around 1,000 kilometers per second.
That's very quick. I'm not sure if that's very realistic. That's like hypervelocity levels. You can get with three-body interactions. You can get like stars flung at these hypervelocities at like 800 kilometers per second. And then there's supernova explosions, which are asymmetric, and they can result in the neutron star that's sometimes left over, if not a black hole, if anything, to then just be like launched off at like 1500 kilometers per second, which is zooming. So 1000 kilometers, like, how did Uranus get up to that sort of speed? Who knows? I'm not actually too sure what speed it's traveling around the sun, though. I would like to find that out if someone can comment down under, because I don't know everything. But I mean, I know a lot about the orbit. Like, it's kind of like going around the sun like a bowling ball. It's like spinning like a ball, whereas all the other planets are kind of like spinning like tabletops. Uranus is on like this 99 degree tilt. It's very unusual, and we're pretty sure something with the mass of like Earth to three times Earth hit Uranus early on and gave it this weird axis and the rings. It's got like 13 rings and they're spinning over the top. It's very beautiful. I feel like there was something, we stopped this for some other reason, but anyway,
because of this unexpectedly fast speed, we'd only have about 30 days left on this planet. Uranus would shine like a bright blue star in the sky.
So they said they're not going to give a realistic scenario here. They just said they don't know why. But I can think of a couple, or maybe not for Uranus, but for planets in general. I was reading some stuff recently, and they showed when stars pass by our system, they can actually make our solar system like collapse, essentially. All they have to do is nudge Neptune like 0.1% off its typical orbit, and then we could be stuffed, because these guys, these scientists simulated in computers like 3,000 times, and they out of 2,000 of them, they found like they ended in 26 of them with Mercury either colliding with Earth or Venus, or Neptune or Uranus just being flung out of the solar system, or Mercury as well. And what happens is Jupiter and Mercury at their perihelion, I can't even say it, which is like their closest point to the sun during their orbit, if they sync up, it can cause this scenario, which would be very bad. So that's a scenario for Mercury hitting Earth. I don't know about how we get... Actually, I can think of another thing, primordial black holes. So these are theoretical. We don't know if they exist. They could be real. You can go look into those. I'm not going to talk too much about it, but they could just be roaming around the galaxy. And if one was just coming straight at us, it could wander into our solar system and just wreak havoc and push everything around because they've got so much mass. And then, potentially knock the outer planets towards us. Anyway, let's keep going.
Sky, and every day it would appear bigger and brighter. Our sky would look gorgeous, not only because of the ice giant shining down on us, but also thanks to many shooting stars. Only those wouldn't be stars at all. Might as well enjoy the view.
At least we're going out with a bang, straight into Uranus, planet in the solar system, though. I wanted to briefly talk about its moons, because it's got such cool moons. We'll stick with this shot. It's a beautiful shot. But it's got like 27 moons, apparently, and they're all the Shakespearean moons. They're all named after Shakespeare characters and Alexander Pope. There's some funky ones. And I think my favorite is Umbria. Is it Umbria? It is the darkest of the moons and the most mysterious. There's also one called Puck, a ring moon. It comes in between the rings. The rings are quite colorful as well. And then what's my other? Miranda. Miranda actually might be the most mysterious. They're both very mysterious. But like I said before, we've only been to the moon. I mean, this to see Uranus once with a space probe. That was Voyager 2 back in the late 70s. And it was only there for like, it only had, it was getting good data of this place for about 45 hours. On its journey, through the system. And we got a lot of cool data, but we haven't had much more since. We have to sort of get stuff from, through telescopes, which is unfortunate because all of these moons around Uranus might have water, you know, underground oceans. We think they might. It seems like they all might. So we should get back there and check it out. But like we were saying before, it's so far away, it's kind of really out of our limit currently. We can barely, you know, feasibly, theoretically make it to Mars. A human getting to Uranus? No way. I mean, it's possible for sure, but not with current tech. I mean, wouldn't it be great? Send me NASA. But in about 11 years from memory, 2030. Wait, that's not 11 years. What am I talking about? No, the journey will take about 11 years. With current tech. The planets are going to align in such a way we'll be able to get to Uranus. You know, we'll be able to make the quickest journey for a while. It takes like 84 years for Uranus to go around the sun. What was I going to say? Yeah, so we can get some gravity assist if we do this at the right time. And, you know, you could name it the Shakespeare probe. It would just be really interesting because all these moons potentially have water. Uranus is still a complete mystery. You know, like we have lots of theoretical stuff like what's going on. There'd be lots of... It's such a high-pressure environment in Uranus. There'd be some funky quantum states of strange elements, that's for sure. And as you probably got closer to the surface, the rock surface, they would condense into like a thin soup. Anyway, let's continue.
Planet.
Let's see what
volcanoes
happens.
Volcanoes would begin erupting uncontrollably.
Yes.
And tremendous earthquakes would get in on the act, destroying the Earth from the inside. And the stink. You'd drop unconscious from even one whiff of it because, well, I mean, Uranus smells like farts. The ice giant's upper atmosphere is mostly composed of hydrogen sulfide. It's the same stuff that makes rotten eggs reek so bad. Imagine an
Lovely.
Entire planet of rotten eggs engulfing the Earth. Blah! The thought of it makes me nauseous. But Uranus wouldn't come alone. It would bring all of its 27 moons along for the ride.
He's talking
and
about the moons.
Those moons would be hitting the Earth from all sides.
Maybe.
As a fart-filled finale, Uranus would compress what was left of our atmosphere, and the rapidly rising temperatures would ignite it.
I guess this
Just
is if
like
it's a direct collision, you know, because things would generally like spiral. And then, you know, a lot of things will get ripped apart before they even collide, especially, you know, Uranus is 15 times larger. So there's this thing called the rush limit. But if it's direct collision, I think they might actually collide. It'd be pretty interesting. But anyway, let's continue.
Our beautiful blue planet would fall in line and start circling the ice giant, eventually becoming one of its many moons. Uranus wouldn't get away with this assault so easily, however. Last time
Salting
it collided
Uranus.
With another planetary object twice the size of Earth, it
Don't
tipped
demonetize
over.
Me, YouTube.
Yeah, Uranus is the only planet in our neighborhood
this.
That spins on its side. This impact, featuring our earthly home, could help tilt it back to how it once was. But for the Earth, we know that would be it. If by some unexplained mystery, life on Earth's stinking leftovers.
So it's about 15 times larger than the mass of Earth, but if you relax, you get 16.
First, once again, we would see
I feel like
the
I can't
blue
say that on YouTube.
Of Uranus on the horizon.
It was not
it would look
YouTube appropriate.
Just as cool as if the Earth was one of Jupiter's
Apologies.
Moons.
Forgive
but
me.
That's a story. For
All right, let's see what's in the comments. That was a great video. I'm impressed. We can watch some more of this guy. Great channel, but let's check out these comments. Surely, there's gotta be some jokes, man. What if Uranus collided with Earth? We would have a crap ton of problems. Yep. And what is this horrific stink? Uranus would look about the size of the moon. Uranus will grow bigger and brighter, and the sky would look gorgeous. If this really does happen, it's going to be the most hilarious way we die. Yep. for sure. Props to the person. Jokes are still funny. Even, yeah, they're always funny. Come on, who's got a funny joke for me? Uranus would start shaking things up. What would happen if Uranus collided with Earth? It would be a pain in the ass. Well done. Well done, madam. Uranus wouldn't get away with this assault so easily. Uranus would go through an asteroid field. God, that would hurt. What would happen to the moon if it entered its orbit? Our moon? Its orbit? Well, it depends how close it got. If it got too close, it would get ripped apart. It's generally what causes rings. You know, sometimes moons, sometimes they're created from the formation of the planet itself because there'd be an accretion disk as it forms. Anyway, what you doing? I'm about to go into Uranus. Jesus Christ, man. I'm confused. If the moon came toward Earth, it would break up from the Russians. Yeah, this guy gets it. I think because they're coming directly, if they're going fast enough, there'd probably be a bit of a collision. Yet Earth won't break up under Uranus around a little bit. Earth would straight up be swallowed by Uranus. Yeah, we're getting swallowed by Uranus. I believe this is one of the scariest scenarios. I mean, imagine knowing that Uranus was going to destroy the planet. I'm sure children would endlessly cry. We'd all have to evacuate the planet. How would we do that? I mean, us whole. It'd be a nightmare. You could probably get a somewhat accurate simulation with Universe Sandbox. It's a great game. It's good fun. Come on, who's got a good question for me? Okay, last comment. I'm curious. Would the temperature difference affect Uranus since it would be closer to the sun? For sure, my friend. It would no longer be the coldest planet in the system. Would the ice melt before we got hit? It's not like the whole thing's just going to disappear. but yeah, some of it. But like I said, there's not that. Yeah. Anyway, would the speed at which Uranus is traveling have any effect on the planet itself? Yep. Yep. Really depends how it gets up to that speed. You know, if it was gradual, if it just went. also, yeah, of course. But it's already traveling very quickly. You got to remember this. Like, the rate at which it's zooming around the sun would be fairly enormous. If it takes 84 years for an orbit and it's, you know, from Earth, what did we say, 3 light hours away. So you do the math, that's very quick. what else you say? We're just curious if anyone knows. Not an astrophysicist. No, not, never silly, my friend. They were great questions. All right, that'll do, guys. That'll do. Go sign up for CalVPN. I'd very much appreciate it. Thanks for everyone who has. And I'll catch you next time. Leave a video down under if you want me to react to it. I need suggestions.